One popular argument against young Earth creation is that of the Native American people. When did they get to America? Where are they from? The secular view is that 15 to 20,000 years ago, they crossed the Bering Strait. So they think because their model claims this, then our model must be invalid. Well, let's stop for a second and think about this. What makes people migrate? Famine, war, civil unrest, these are the main causes. Well, since genetics has shown us that Native Americans are of Asian descent, more on that soon, we have to look to Asia to see what events may have caused a migration away from Asia, and in what direction they might have gone to determine the actual model. Not just throw out a random number without any evidence. Well, we see in 100 to 500 AD, the Roman Empire was expanding and going to war with everyone around it. They battled the Huns in Central Asia. And if we look at the Chinese calendars, we can actually see that their worst period in history falls on the Age of Unrest at that period in time. Since the safest way to migrate would have been east, it makes logical sense that they would have fled from a war-torn country to new lands. So this was most likely what caused migration. But there are other ways to tell if this is true. Another way to tell is language. Diachronic linguist Joseph Greenberg was investigating languages and discovered that the presumed 163 language families of today is actually much lower at just 83 or maybe less. This falls in line with Genesis 10, which tells us of the Babel dispersion of languages, which would be around 70. The language family of Native Americans fell within the high-level linguistic Amerind family, combining all indigenous people of South America, North America, Alaska, Nunavut, and Greenland. You find the same conclusion in the book The Historical Linguistics of Native Americans, written in 1997. Lyell Campbell listed several hypotheses of the historical origins of the Amerindian language families. The first agrees with Greenberg's in that a single one-language migration event is the best and most obvious. We should always apply Occam's razor whenever possible, and this is one of those cases. Next, genetic evidence. We have tested Native Americans and found they all contain the haplogroup group Q. Now this Q only shows up in two people groups in Asia. So now we have the best evidence of all, biological evidence. This tells us the story of how migration happened, and we can see it in two events. The first was pushed east over the Bering Strait. The later migration went west and settled in Florida. When looking for documents in Native Americans in their own words, you can find a book called The Red Record. In it tells of not only the migration pattern, but how cold it was and how much ice there was when they traveled and then where they finally settled. So now we have multiple pieces of evidence that have all helped us puzzle together the history of America, which shows that natives migrated from Asia. They arrived far more recently than secular sources assumed. They are part of a larger linguistic family and are traced genetically from Asia. War most likely pushed them into migration to America based on historical records. No more is there any mystery as to why the native people were here before anyone else discovered America, and it doesn't conflict at all with the young Earth creation timeline.